So I know CT temple bone can be more challenging than other type of neural imaging like head CT or brain MR, but hopefully you get the correct diagnosis of D. labyrinthitis ossificans. So let's look at some of the features that makes labyrinthitis ossificans the best choice here. And also remember the history here is very, very helpful because they talk about left-sided hearing loss. So you can assume that the right side is a normal side for comparison. So if you compare to the right side where the inner ear structure should be loosened, and on the abnormal left side, you can see the cochlea has abnormal density inside. The posterior semicircular canal also looks abnormally dense. On the coronal view, you see the spiral shape or the snail shape cochlea is abnormally dense. So that's the hallmark for labyrinthitis ossificans. If I were to show you a MRI, I will show you that there's a loss of T2 signal within a heavily T2 weighted sequence, so the cochlea will be dark on T2 weighted sequence. And on board exam, they can also ask you the etiology for labyrinthitis ossificans, and the most common cause is some type of infection, most commonly meningitis or otomastoiditis. But essentially, anything that can cause inflammation or irritation, infection inside the inner ear. So, for example, blood got into inner ear structure either through surgery or trauma or any type of autoimmune process that can cause labyrinthitis ossificans. Now, what about other answers that do not work as well in this case? So for choice ABC, otosclerosis, otospongiosis. As you know, otosclerosis is otospongiosis. They are the same thing, even though they sound kind of opposite to each other, but they are the same entity. For otospongiosis or otosclerosis, instead of abnormal density inside, you should see abnormal lucency outside. So as you know, a normal outer capsule should be dense bone. So if you see this abnormal lucency outside, that's otospongiosis or otosclerosis. And in this case, this extensive form surrounding the cochlea is the retrofenestrial or the cochlear form of the otospongiosis. For the cochlear aplasia, sometimes the cochlea would not develop, so therefore you see the entire thing is white out. The thing here is that you can still see the cochlea. The cochlea is formed, but it's abnormal dense inside. So therefore, this is not cochlear aplasia. Another way you can tell the difference between cochlear aplasia versus a severe labyrinthitis ossificans is that you should see formation of cochlear promontory in the case of labyrinthitis ossificans. And where in the case of cochlear aplasia, a lot of time you don't see a properly formed cochlear promontory. If you have any questions, please let me know. Good luck on your board exam.